This is Darshna Savla here on behalf of Dress My Craft, and I welcome you all to this very beautiful world of shrink print frosted glass sheets. And today I'll be showing you all how to use them and how to create amazing stuff out of it. So you can see here there is a beautiful display of the projects that I have made, and they are amazing jewelries. You can also use these sheets to create your home decor accessories. You can create floral bouquets, you can use curtain bands, napkin rings. Also, you can use them to create your scrapbooking embellishments, and the possibilities are endless. So let us explore this amazing world of shrink print frosted glass sheets. And here are the amazing different shades of shrink print frosted glass sheets. In total, we have 20 shades. The one shade is absolutely plain on which you can color it. And there are 19 different other shades which you need not color them. They are for direct use. So you have the yellows, reds, pinks, magentas, peaches, a family of English pinks, mauves, lavenders, silver, golden, blues and greens, grays and the plain ones. Now let's see how are we going to make very beautiful flowers with this. And here is the amazing collection of dyes from Dress My Craft. These floral dyes are absolutely perfect in size, perfect in shape to create amazing shrink print flowers. And here are the die cutouts for the same. So here is an amazing different colors, and here are the calyx ones for the greens. Here is also the greens, and you can see very beautiful flowers, golden, silver, mauves, blues, peaches and purples. And we'll see how to create this very beautiful flowers from the same. So here the frosted sheets are already pre-cut out in the colored sheets as it is, which you need not color. In case if you are using the plain color as well, so I'll show you all how to do the coloring for the same. So we will be using the soft pastels from Mungyu, and on the frosted side we will be taking the soft pastels. So with your finger, first of all, let us pick up the lightest baby pink here, and we will rub it all over the petal here like this. Give one single coat all around the entire petal to get one single color all over the plain side, that is the frosted side. Once you have finished giving one color coat to the entire flower cutout, we will be taking a little bit of a darker pink shade, and I'll be putting this darker pink shade just in the center. So by adding a dark color in the center, you will get some dimension to this flower. And now we will see how to emboss this plain one as well as the colored ones. Here we have one set of colored sheet die cut out, and here we have the plain one on which we had colored. So to emboss these petals, we need the heat resistant embossing foam pad from Dress My Craft, and it has been covered with the fabric sleeves. Also, just to make sure that, you know, the shrink print sheets when you heat it do not stick to the base. And here we have these three different sizes. Just to make sure that you are passing through the wires or the beads to create your jewelry, you need a hole to pass through the wires. So here we have the three different sizes of hand punches. Depending upon the size of the flower, we will be selecting the size of the hand punch. If this is a smaller flower, I will be using the smaller hand punch, and I'll be punching a hole right in the center to make sure that the right size of the wires will pass through it. If I have a middle size of a flower, I will be using the middle size of the punch. If I have the larger flower, I will be using the larger size of the punch. So this will help you to pass through the wires very easily. In case if you use the smaller size of the punch to the larger flower, when your petals will shrink, you might end up sealing the holes. So it is better to have the perfect sizing when you are going to use different sizes of flowers. Also, we will be needing the ball tools, and we need the heat resistant tweezers. These are fine tip, excellent grip, ceramic tip tweezers which will help you hold the petals in place. At the same time, they would not burn your fingers. And we have the amazing Dress My Craft heat embossing gun. So with the help of this, the petals will shrink and you can create amazing stuff out of it. So first let us take the bigger size. So you can keep either the shiny side up or you can keep the frosted side up. Depending upon your requirement, you can decide. Make sure that you are holding the petal right in the center. Make sure that the tweezer tips are absolutely closed tight. That will help you to place the petal in place. And this is a dual control heat embossing gun. So depending upon your requirement, you can either do it on a one number or you can do it on the two numbers. So let us get started with the heat embossing and make sure that you are embossing all around uniformly the heat so that the petals shrink uniformly all over and you can get amazing beautiful flowers with this shrink. And now you can see the magic. The petals have started curling up and they are going to go back in its place and you can see the very beautiful shrinking. And look at this. So you put the ball tool right in the center and make sure that you curve the tip of the petals so that you will get a very beautiful tiny little floral bloom and it will add some dimension to the flower. So finally the tips of the petals have been curved up and look at this amazing, gorgeous, beautiful flower. And let us see the second size as well. To complete these flowers, you can add very beautiful pearls in the center or you can use the diamond studs. So here are the gorgeous unicorn pink and green beads or you can use any color that you wish to right in the center. So let me pick up this very beautiful pink color and with the help of E6000, you can stick these pearls in the center. So you can take a little bit of E6000 here, little bit. Get very beautiful centers of the flowers and this is how you can complete your flowers and create very beautiful projects from the same. So here are the very beautiful flowers that have been created using the shrink frame colored sheets. Here are the very beautiful family of pinks. In this you can see the silvers and the goldens. Here we have the pinks, the peaches and the sky blue and here we have the reds, the pinks and the yellows and they all just look so amazing. So get started creating amazing shrink frame flowers.